Okay, welcome to another Bleistift video. Today I want to look at the Caveco Special or Caveco Special 0.5. Okay, it's written with a C and the decimal point is not a comma, so I assume this is supposed to be pronounced the English way, so let's call it the Caveco Special. I put a clip on mine. And what is it? It's an 0.5 millimeter mechanical pencil. And usually I like pencils to be quite fine, the lead. I like 0.2 and 0.3 millimeter. 0.5 is already a bit on the wide side. Yeah, let's have a look with the different statistics. Let's make some notes. And yeah, let's find out more about the pen. So it's the Caveco Special 0.5 millimeter. Okay, colors and variations. There's this version, which is, I think, black and aluminium. And there's a brass version. I asked Caveco and I was told the black version came out in 2011 and the brass version came out in 2016. Okay, let's have a closer look at the body, grip diameter and so on. Okay, here we are. Yeah, 9.65 centimeters. 9.65 millimeters, not centimeters. Let's try again here. Let's do 9.65 millimeters. Made in Germany. But I was told the mechanism is from Japan. Okay, let's check the weight. Oh, yeah. Here we are. Let's say 18 gram. Weight is 18 gram. Okay, how does that compare to other hexagonal pencils? Because there are quite a few around. Here's one from Caran d'Ache. Here's one from Mucci. So, yeah, how does it compare? You can see the Caveco has a bigger diameter. Weight-wise, Caran d'Ache is a bit lighter. Mucci is a bit lighter. So it's a bit heavier and with a bigger diameter than some of the other hexagonal pencils out there. Center of gravity. Oh, I forgot to. Let me just have a look. So center of gravity, what I normally do is I've got this little type. Here we are. So I normally balance if I check the center of gravity, I try to balance the pen on the type. So at least with the clip on, the center of gravity is kind of in the middle of the pen. Okay. Middle. I have 18 gram here. The weight is with the clip. Yeah, because the clip, the pen doesn't come with the clip. You can remove it. Yeah. But I like a pen with a clip, then I can put it in my pocket. It doesn't roll away, but you know, that's not too much of a problem with this pen because of the shape. Check the length. Oops. Length is roughly 14 centimeters. That's a pretty normal length for a pen. Here, let's compare it with the other hexagonal pens. Let's throw a rod ring into the mix. Yeah, a pretty standard length here. Eraser. Let's check the eraser. Wait, okay, there is an eraser here. Yeah, since we're taking it apart anyway, let's have a look at the mechanism. Yeah. Typical, probably brass, or certainly some sort of metal mechanism. So yeah, there is an eraser, oops. Lead capacity, okay, let's find out how many leads we can put in this pen. Okay, let's empty what's in here. Okay, seems to be empty. Ten? Yeah. I think I could fit quite a few more in. So let's stop here. Let's say we can fit more than 10 in. Let's put the original LEDs back. Lead capacity more than 10. Speciality, the looks maybe. I mean, it's not like this pen can do anything specific. The sleeve is not retractable, it's not sliding. So let's say specialty looks. Clutch mechanism, yeah, it looked like a metal or some certainly brass type. It's the traditional clutch mechanism. You see often. Price. In the UK, they are a bit, this version is 30, 35 pounds, something like that. Let's have a look in America. America, it seems to be around $45, and on the continent, it seems to be €35. Overall, it's a nice pen. It has a bit of a more traditional look. Yeah, like I said, this version came out in 2011, I was told. But it's based on a historic Caveco special, which is from the 1930s. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.